story you saw first on 5, a deer jumps off an overpass and crashes through a woman's windshield. She told her story only to News 5 and shared with us these horrifying images from that day 1 year ago. But tonight, Tracy Truby also wants to share a different story, how research at University Hospital helped her recover. News 5's Amy Wagner, who's covered Tracy's ordeal from the start, joins us again. Amy?
Well, Jack, I can tell you that Tracy's recovery is truly remarkable. When I sat down with Tracy in December, she would pause for several seconds before answering each question I asked her. Well, today, I was amazed at the difference just 6 months has made.
I feel blessed. I just feel like a miracle. And
even though Tracy Truby doesn't remember the event that changed her life last May, when she sees these pictures, she knows it's a miracle. She's here to talk about it.
My recovery in and of itself is, it's amazing. It really is.
Doctors agree. Considering last May, Tracy was driving north on I-71 just as a deer leapt from the 275 overpass above and crashed through her windshield, sending her car flipping out of control.
The pictures are shocking because the deer in the passenger seat and had landed right on me and took out the steering column.
Tracy was in a coma, barely clinging to life. Her husband made the crucial decision to enroll her in a study called PROTECT for traumatic brain injuries at University Hospital.
We have been very, very fortunate that with this PROTECT trial, we are bringing the best abilities of our trauma surgeons, our neurosurgeons, and our emergency physicians together to provide this care.
Today, Tracy returned to the hospital she believes saved her life and her brain.
I'm grateful to be a success story.
So she's returned to thank every doctor and emergency worker who helped save her life, believing because of them, her story continues.
I'm really looking forward to the future.
And Tracy feels there is a reason for her remarkable recovery. And she says many of the soldiers returning from Iraq and Afghanistan have traumatic brain injuries. She's determined to help them.